Hi friends, namaste. Hope you are keeping well during this unusual situation where utmost care is needed for ourselves and our near and dear. Thank you Sunday Tribune for organizing the webinar. A big thank you to our president, Mr. Cyril Ramaphosa, for making good decisions at the right time. This is the reason why we are doing better than some other countries in this pandemic. Due to the numerous requests for my astrological take on COVID-19, today I will speak to you about how it came about, its peak, and when we can expect to overcome it. Just a brief intro about myself. I am Mahesh Bang. I am an astrologer, palmist, numerologist, and vastu consultant. I have been an astrologer for the past 25 years, and I am writing an astrology column every Sunday without fail for the last 16 years for Sunday Tribune Herald. I am formerly from India, but now settled here in South Africa. I studied astrology for many years in India, but still I'm constantly studying and researching, as learning is a never-ending process with such a great amount of knowledge to discover. With infinite combinations of astrological equations, I have also been fortunate enough to learn from many spiritual gurus throughout my journey as an astrologer. Another significant milestone in my career was meeting Bollywood icon Sanjay Dutt in 2003. Following a successful reading, he then started introducing me to the world of Bollywood as an astrologer. Another very productive milestone was the opportunity of serving as Sunday Tribune resident astrologer weekly, and so being able to help others through the advice in my column. To date, I would have given more than 3,000 replies. In this way, I feel blessed. Today, we will cover two topics. Firstly, my astrological research on COVID-19 and its outcome, which is much awaited. Secondly, as we all know, any child can even tell you that a recession is knocking on the doors of most countries. So we will touch a bit on this. This pandemic is a story of humankind and nature. In the age of technology, we move so fast that we forget our role in the universe. Now is the time to rethink and make necessary changes. We are merely the galloping horses, and Mother Nature will always hold the reins. So we must adapt to the situation, do more introspection and prayer, improve on our personalities, and read spiritual texts. My condolences to those who have lost their loved ones, and we send much light and love to those who are critically ill due to COVID-19. As we are talking on this, just to mention that my wife is a medical doctor, so I'm aware of what an impact and sacrifice that our frontline workers are doing. So another big salute to frontline workers like doctors, nurses, police, army, and our people who are following the social norms, and also those kind angels who are distributing the food parcels for the needy. I am grateful to Sunday Tribune, who celebrated the success of my column of 15 years by organizing the high tea event held in December 2019 at the Suncoast Hotel. This event was specifically held at this time to inform others of the rare planetary configuration that was going to occur during Christmas time last year. This is where I said on that Christmas 2019, there were six planets coming in one zodiac sign, and it was a very, very rare configuration. As we know, these planets revolves around the sun at different revolving speeds. It takes time to come in one zodiac sign. It happens 3 to 4 times in a century. At that time, I went on to say that this equation was present in the First World War, Second World War, Indochina War, plague and drought periods of time, and in 2000 and 2002, after these periods of time, and in 2000 and 2002, you can see Twin Tower, 9/11, a series of earthquakes to follow. Whenever this happens, something happens in the world that needs the world's attention. Some incident will trigger the world. I also said on various platforms, this planetary configuration in the transit are not favorable for the Earth. Misfortune will take place. Around this time, some occurrence will plant the seed for a worldwide negative incident in the coming year that will draw global attention. If you have been following me on Facebook and other forms of media, then please get a sneak preview in more detail for your interest. Thank you so much to all of you for sharing these videos on social media. Following this, leading news agencies unfolded this prediction and find it to be a world health war type situation. Again, China affected being the origin, started in the month of December 2019, and where plague, now it grew to a pandemic amongst others. Then many media houses around the world showed interest in my astro research on COVID-19. Some of these are Outlook, Leading Magazine of India, NewsGram from USA, BDC TV from Boston, and Bhaskar Live, India's leading newspaper. So now, my friends, I will share this research of mine with you. This COVID-19 is due to multiple planetary factors that caused the pandemic. So the relief or improvement from this disease will occur in stages. I will give some insight into my research and some of the reasons as to why I say this. Without the influence of the two largest planets of our solar system, that is Saturn and Jupiter, no significant event would take place in our lifespan. Their gravitational pull is so strong because of their large masses and slowest revolving speeds around the sun. After approximately every 20 years, Saturn and Jupiter comes together in one zodiac sign and are closely associated in less than 30 degrees to each other. Whenever this occurs, it negatively affects the world, sometimes giving birth to a pandemic type of situation. But let's not go more deeper with astrological calculations and the placement. This may get a little complicated. The most significant factors I have understood out of this is that the biggest historical events which occurred whenever these planets were in one zodiac sign or very closely associated in the last 100 years cycles are: in the year 1920, there was a Spanish flu pandemic. From 1939 to 1945, this was the time when the Second World War occurred. In 1962 and 63, During these years, we saw extreme tensions between China and India that led to the Indo-China war and poisoned the relationship. In the year 1981, the HIV virus pandemic began. This was an introduction of a new disease to the world. Mid-99 to 2001, there was a war between India and Pakistan that is known as the Kargil War. And there was a fear for a bit that these countries could have used nuclear weapons. There was also a very massive earthquake in Bhuj in Gujarat in India. Also, the 9/11 Twin Tower incident that occurred at that time. Now, from December 2019 to 30th June 2020, this period led to the horrific Australian fires, America, Iran tussle, volcano, and now COVID-19 pandemic. So we can see that in the last 100 years, every 20 years astrologically and also astronomically, when they come closer, these planets, something major occurs. If we look more into the past, then 1347 was one of the worst plagues the world saw, known as the Black Death. It is noteworthy that 3 out of 6 incidents involve viruses, diseases, pandemics. Another interesting fact is that all 3 pandemics have a common astrological fact, that is Rahu and Ketu, 2 shadow planets, were present in Gemini and Sagittarius sign respectively. So for these reasons, at the end of July to the end of September, we may see some improvement in the disease when these shadow planets will not be situated with Saturn planet. This is our first stage or first opportunity when the virus can become weaker. If things go astray from the pattern noticed in the past, then we can only expect significant improvement after 4th April 2021. Astrologically, on 20th November 2020, we will again enter a difficult phase as the planet Saturn and Jupiter will be present together in one zodiac sign, that is Capricorn. So between 20th November 2020 to 4th April 2021 will, dear friends, again be another difficult time for the world. This period will see either the second wave of COVID-19 or climax of conflict between countries like America and China, or the peak of the economic depression, or something enigmatic that we haven't seen before. We will talk on this closer to time. On 2nd Feb 2020, in Sunday Tribune Herald, when COVID-19 was limited only to China, I had warned about the period between March 29 and June 30, indicating that it would be tough for the world. And unfortunately, we saw the world over on lockdown. We may now need to brace ourselves for this peak. But my dear friends, I am sorry to say that from 15th May, that is today, to 30th June, when the 2 major planets, Saturn and Jupiter, are in retrograde and they are already situated together in one zodiac sign. Beside this, in the next 30 days, 3 different eclipses will occur. This can mark the peak of COVID-19 in South Africa, India, and few other countries. This will be the time to take extra precautions. But on a positive note, only divine intervention will help us to overcome this pandemic quicker. This is the time we all need to take care of the environment and do more introspection and focus on our goal in human life and humanity. My friends, before I give you my final astrological take on COVID-19, I want to say that if you are still not allowed to work due to stage 4 or 3, then channelize your energy to positive thoughts. It's a common fact that almost every country and every individual is currently experiencing some financial strain or another. But have strength, my friends. This phase will also improve eventually. Just remember, these kind of calamities unfortunately do occur in human life, and we do need to be able to bear or at least strategize a way to deal with this. Astrologically, this is not the first of its kind and will also not be the last. However, each occurrence of this sort needs a specific approach. For the COVID-19 pandemic, we all need to do some self-analysis and soul-searching. We need to do self-evaluation, see what flaws we may have and how to overcome this. If it was not a real threat, we would never really get a chance to do so. Use this time to advance yourself in pranayama, exercise, meditation, yoga, and prayer. Following a healthy lifestyle and mindset will eventually aid in building up your immune system. And even if we get exposed to this virus, we will heal quicker. We really should be appreciating our loved ones, our bodies and minds. Gratitude should be our attitude. Increase the feeling of gratitude so that we all radiate at a higher consciousness and hopefully in some ways will become more protective. But most importantly, we need to appreciate life itself. Each day and each breath should be one of gratitude to the divine, as we all know that there were many people around the globe that have not been so fortunate to get that extra day. In our current situation, some people are struggling for life and others are struggling for food. If we are not in either of those situations, then we are still more fortunate. We really feel sorry for those who are struggling. Many have been complaining over the years that they have no time. Now, suddenly, we are given more time. If you are not working, then we need to utilize this time by building on our relationship with our parents, spouse, children, and friends. This time will not come again. We especially must make our bond stronger with God and with ourselves. We must also make the time to talk to ourselves. Do not complain if we all are in rain, just to know that you can choose to either enjoy by dancing in the rain or you can feel the wet and then complain. The choice is yours. It's easy to remain positive during this time as it's just a mindset change. It's obvious that because of the confusion and chaos COVID-19 has currently caused, there are bills to pay, a family to feed, etc. These are routine expenditures and some may not have a proper income. Just remember, in this human life of ours, every problem has a solution and this solution will come. I just want to tell you to utilize this time as most people are facing similar problems. Yet, not everyone is walking around with gloomy face. Some have learned how to endure and have patience until the solution or vaccine appears. We can engage ourselves in certain hobbies, reading, writing, gardening, chanting, or a new innovative way to earn a living, etc. You should become a kid with your children, play with them. I am losing every weight in Scrabble with my son. As per the spiritual text, nothing is permanent. Be optimistic as this situation will also change. We pray to God that this pandemic must end soon accept the situation with an optimistic mind and move ahead. Do meditation and increase your faith in God to enable us to pass this time a bit more smoothly. I cannot tell you things will be all right and will end in 1 or 2 weeks' time, as this just is not showing in the astrological charts. It's better to know and understand where we are going so that you can prepare for it. Brace yourselves and don't take that unnecessary loan. Spend wisely. Do not exceed your budget, as this situation will take time. This is a very big lesson for all of us to save money for rainy days. If you need help financially now, your family and friends will find it difficult to help you, as they are also sailing in the same boat. Finally, astrologically, I can tell you that things will only return to normal in all aspects, for the entire globe, only from November 21, 2021, when the planet Jupiter transits over Aquarius. We must also acknowledge that the global horoscope is overpowering each country's individual horoscope for a few months due to the rare configuration that occurred in December last year and the continued unfavorable alignments of the planets that are occurring one after the other. So we need to understand that it will take time, but be patient. Things will improve eventually. Mental health is more vital than physical health. All diseases ultimately originates from the mind first and then affects the body. So do not have a fear regarding COVID-19. In comparison to other pandemics, the mortality rate for COVID-19 is still much, much lower. Like if someone gets a luxury car and a house and someone feels bad about it due to whatever reason why he got it, then you are sending this negative energy in the universe that you feel unhappy, then cosmic energy will never grant you these things. So understand that our thoughts are the most important aspects of our lives, as they ultimately make and shape our destiny. Don't suppress your destiny by being an obstacle in the path of others by having negative thoughts towards them. Ultimately, these negative thoughts will come back to you. Instead, if anyone is not behaving appropriately even at this time, then we must feel sorry for them, as they just need more help to become a better person. Let's, friend, change the world. Let's change the world after this pandemic by having more kindness and compassion in our hearts. So now, do not have fear. Instead, follow the government protocols and medical necessary steps to make your immune system stronger. Aside from the standard precautionary measures that we need to take, I will also give you a few astrological and Ayurvedic most important tips to build up your immune system. Have a glass of warm milk with a pinch of turmeric in it every night. Astrologically, turmeric denotes the planet Jupiter, and doing this would empower this planet more, also known for its Ayurvedic antibiotic properties. Have 4 to 6 tulsi leaves every day with water, also known as holy basil. Please tear the leaves and form a small bundle, then swallow with water, like the way you would do for a capsule, as tulsi should not be bitten into. By doing this, the planet Mercury is strengthened. Mercury controls skin and surfaces, therefore it would astrologically make this tougher to penetrate, also known for its immune buildup Ayurvedically. In the morning, before brushing your teeth, drink 2 glasses of warm water, as this is known to improve your immune power, as 70% of our body and the earth is made of water. Water is controlled by the moon. By beginning our day with water, we are strengthening our lungs, as the moon affects lung and respiratory tracts. Eat more vegetarian, eat more vegetables and try to be vegetarian. One last astrological tip that is great if you can afford is to donate 7 different grains according to your body weight at least once a year to a needy people or a spiritual organization. If you cannot afford, then at least do one kind of grain. And if you cannot afford this, then no worries. At least have care, kindness and compassion towards others and pray. Whatever your faith is during this time, my Muslim brothers should follow the teachings from Islam. My Christian brothers from the Bible. If you follow Hinduism, then you should read Shri Hanuman Chalisa daily to remove fear and anxiety. Whenever you are reading this chapai, Nashe Rog Hare Sab Pira Japat Nirantar Hanumant Bira, read it aloud with full determination, as it means, O Lord Hanuman, you destroy diseases and remove all pains when one utters your name continuously. After reading Hanuman Chalisa, read the Sankat Mochan, an antidote for all problems. After the lockdown, you can collect complimentary copies of these if you don't have. Be strong, my friends. Life is not coming to an end. There was a date in December 2012 when many said that the world is coming to an end. It became viral and there was even a movie about it. But I checked and media published my story that the entire month was going to be absolutely normal. And see, we are here. Nothing happened. Thank you for listening and giving me your valuable time. My dear friends, as we know, as we have to live with this pandemic for some time together, please carry on life with precautions and follow some of the advice given, as we must keep the harmony and peace without panic or fear. Just remember to be helpful to your destiny by thinking positive and always having good intention as a productive member of society. For further future astrological updates regarding COVID-19, kindly follow on my FB page. Wishing you well, take care, stay safe, stay healthy, stay smiling. Once again, thank you so much. If you want to know specific remedies for each zodiac sign, then let us continue. I did some research and I will let you know now. Aries, do control your anger. Don't overexert yourself. Taurus, do control your sweet intake. Don't be overconfident. Gemini, do take tulsi leaves, holy basil. Don't allow fear and anxiety to enter your mind. Cancer, have ginger tea every morning. Don't eat seafood. Leo, be more in sunlight. Don't let your ego get the better of you. Virgo, spend more time with your family. Don't entertain gossip. Libra, donate grains according to your body weight. Don't laze around. Scorpio, increase your intake of water. Don't overreact any situation. Sagittarius, drink turmeric milk every day. Don't be harsh in your words. Capricorn, do more prayer. Don't stay awake at night. Aquarius, do eat more citrus fruit. Don't overthink. Pisces, shower 2 times per day. Don't eat meat. Wishing you great immunological strength and stamina along with protection and safety for you and your loved ones. So thank you so much for listening to me and giving your valuable times. Looking forward to chat to you again. Thank you. Namaste.